Tennessee.
Lord, I've really been real stressed, down and out, losing trust. Although I am black and brown, problems got me pessimistic. Brothers and sisters keep messing up. Why does it have to be so damn tough? I don't know where I can go to let these ghosts out of my skull. My grandma passed, my brother's gone. I never at once felt so alone. I know you're supposed to be my steering wheel, not just my spare tire.
Down to Peachtree. Headliner, I challenge you to a game of horseshoes. A game of horseshoes!
Now I see the importance of history. Why my baby be in the mess of baby? Many journeys to freedom made in fame by brothers on the corner playing ghetto games. I ask you, Lord, why you enlighten me without the enlightenment of all my folks? He said, cause I set myself on a quest for truth, and he was there to quench my thirst. But I am still thirsty. Allow me to drink some more. He said, what I am searching for are the answers to all which are in front of me. The ultimate truth started to get blurry. For some strange reason, it had to be. It was all a dream about Tennessee.
Take me to
Shabbat Shalom, Yashra. Shabbat Shalom. I hope all is well tonight. Where do I begin? Well, you know, just like that song, just how that song was revealed to me. Mind you, I used to jam out to that when I was a kid, but was totally oblivious to the lyrics. And the same way he revealed, re-revealed, I guess you could say, that song to me. And that method is the same method that he uses to lead me to where he is leading me. It's supernatural. To the world, it seems crazy. And crazy is just a term like a conspiracy theorist. It's a term that the world uses to dismiss something that it doesn't understand. They don't know how to explain the wonders of the Most High. So they dismiss it and label it with things like conspiracy theorists or crazy. And some days, yes, it does seem crazy, because it's mind-blowing even to someone who's looking for it. When I came out of Mitzrayim, the Most High spoke to me in ways that I had never been spoken to before. And it's all been about the same objective, and that is to go to the set apart place. And if you think that in no way could be literal, let me remind you that there's nothing the Most High doesn't think of. He's got it all locked down. He does it spiritually, but also physically. And who are you to say that he can't, or he won't, or he didn't? You're no one to say. You're someone, if you know what's best for you, you'll humble yourself and stay in your lane and let the boss call the shots. Because that objective has been the same throughout this whole journey, that's what we're going to focus on. We are going to read 77. And I hope you've been paying attention and watching how everything falls into place. If you're a watchman and you're watching, therefore, you've seen the signs. You've heard the rumors. You understand what the image of the beast is, what it does, how it operates. So you see truth and you're searching for it, and you'll take it wherever you can get it. Yeah, yeah. But remember, all things are done for the will of the Most High. Yeah. So you can thank Him for anything good you receive. That land is the promised land that the Most High led Moses up to Mount Nebo on and showed him all the inherited land that Yahshua was to inherit, but he would not for his transgression. His lack of faith, his unwillingness to move and operate under the will of the Most High, regardless of the circumstance or the consequence. If if you want to make it and inherit that land, you're going to have to do like Abraham and walk, leave Ur, Babylon, and physically take your rear end to the land that you have inherited if you show up. Let's read chapter 77, and then I'm gonna go back and put a few nuggets made of concrete right here for anyone who's searching for truth, who's on their journey to that place. And if you think there is no place, like always, I'll offer you to prove me wrong. You won't, because you can't. But when you see the truth of which I speak, and I only speak it because it comes from the mouth of the Most High, Abba Yahuwah, that's His name. Don't ever get it twisted. He is the Most High, our wonderful Creator. He gets all honor, all praise, all glory, and every bit of esteem. 77, and then I'm going to show you a few nuggets that came from Him. And remember, they're made of concrete. You will not find error within them. They're fact. Psalms 77. My voice is to the Most High, and I cry. My voice is to my mighty Most High, and He listened to me. In the day of my distress, I sought Yahuwah. My hand was stretched out in the night, and it did not cease. My being refused to be comforted. I remembered the Most High and groaned. I complained, and my spirit grew faint. Salah. You ceased the watches of my eyes. I was too troubled to speak. I have thought about the days of old, the years long past. I remember my song in the night. I meditate within my heart, and my spirit searches diligently. Would Yahuwah reject forever and never again be pleased? Has His loving commitment ceased forever? Has the promise failed for all generations? Has El forgotten to show favor? Has He shut up His compassions in displeasure, Salah? And I said, this is my grief, that the right hand of the Most High has changed. I remember the deeds of Yah, for I remember your wonders of old, and I shall meditate on all your work and talk of your deeds. Yes, I will. Your way, O my Most High, is in set apartness. Who is a great El like the Most High? You are the El who does wonders. You have made known your strength among the peoples. By your arm you have redeemed your people, the sons of Jacob and Joseph. Salah. The waters saw you, the Most High. The waters saw you, they were afraid. The depths also trembled, the people. The clouds poured out water, the heavens rumbled also. Your arrows flashed back and forth. The voice of your thunder rolled along. The lightnings lit up the world. The earth trembled and shook. Your way was in the sea, and your path in the great waters, and your footsteps were not known. You did lead your people like a flock by the hand of Moshe, Moses, and Aaron. Like I said, moment ago, hopefully you took His hand and allowed Him to lead you like a dance. Hopefully your feet are planted firmly on top of His, and your hands in His hands, and you've allowed the potter to mold you. Take the lead. And you've come to the understanding that your only strength, your only love is in letting him lead and knowing you cannot lead. If you have, and he has pointed you towards that land, you're on a journey. You're experiencing things, wonders that the world, because they can't understand, dismiss and call crazy and insane. If it's not labeling you with such dismissive titles, you're not, through humility, allowing Abba to lead. You're trying to lead with him, which is considering yourself to be the most high or equal to him, which was the doctrine from old, from the garden, that the serpent impressed upon Eve and Adam, that has been impressed upon society ever since. And the biggest problem is that most people don't see that is what they're doing. They don't understand that by their actions, not their feelings or their thoughts, but their actions, clearly says that you do see yourself as equal with the Most High and capable of doing things only he can do. Our actions speak louder than words, right? If yours does, and you still haven't seen the land, I'm going to remind you of a few things, and I'll try to keep our focus upon anyone and everyone coming to that understanding of the land of inheritance and its importance to you as a child of the Most High. Nebo and Israel were, in Deuteronomy it says that the Most High led Moses up to the top of to show him the inherited land, which he would never be a part of, but that Yasharal were to inherit. It says Mount Nebo is an elevated ridge located in Jordan, approximately 710 meters above sea level, part of the Abram mountain range. Mount Nebo is mentioned in the Bible as the place where Moses was granted a view of the promised land before his death. You see there, take note that they wrote 710 meters, elevation 2680 feet. Let's look at this other picture. Nebo in Utah. If you take that T and turn it into a D, you've got Yudah. And when Yahuda was first named, there was no J to call it Judah. So it would have been Utah. Utah. Mount Nebo is the southernmost and highest mountain in the Wasatch Range of Utah. In the United States, and the centerpiece of the Mount Nebo wilderness inside the Utah National Forest. Notice there's no meters mentioned there, but you look down here. Sorry about that. 11,932 feet. Way bigger than the Mount Nebo that they've sold to us in Israel, Isis Ra'el. Why would they put 710 meters there and not mention meters over here? Actually mention the word wilderness over here. Most people will see 710 meters and they'll dismiss it. Because most people, like myself, are going to be accustomed to reading or saying the word feet instead of meters. That's a view from Mount Nebo in Utah, in Judah. They intentionally hide this stuff, but because there's a little thing called rules of engagement, that things like these have to be omitted. Why? Because the boss man says so. That's just a little bit to chew on. I want to do everything seasoned and just the right way. Abba willing. Let's read Jeremiah 48 on the way out and give you just a little bit extra to chew on. Concerning Moab, this is what Yahuwah of hosts, the Most High of Yisrael, said: Woe to Nebo, for it is ravaged. Kiriathaim, I can never say that right, is put to shame, captured. The high stronghold is put to shame and broken down. There is praise for Moab no longer. In Heshbon, they have devised evil against her. Come and let us cut it off as a nation, O madmen. You are also cut off. A sword goes after you. Listen. An outcry from Haranaim, ravaging and great destruction. Moab shall be destroyed. Her little ones shall cry out. For on the ascent to Luhuth, they go up weeping bitterly. For in the descent of Haranaim, I can never say those words right, excuse me, the enemy shall hear a cry of destruction. Flee, deliver your own lives, and be like a bush in the wilderness. There's that wilderness. For because you have trusted in your works and your treasures, you shall be captured, and Chemosh shall go forth and into exile, his priest and his heads together. And a ravager shall come into every city, no one escapes, and the valley shall perish, and the plain be destroyed, as Yahuwah has spoken. Give wings to Moab, for she has to flee away, and her cities become ruined with no one to dwell in them. Cursed is he who is slack in doing the work of Yahuwah, and cursed is he who withholds his sword from blood. Moab has been at ease from his youth, and he has settled on his dregs, and has not been emptied from vessel to vessel, nor has he gone into exile. Therefore his favor has stayed in him, and his fragrance is unchanged. Therefore see, the days are coming, declares Yahuwah, when I shall send him tilters, who shall tilt him over and empty his vessels and break the bottles. And Moab shall be ashamed because of Chemosh, as the house of Yisrael was ashamed of Beth-El, their refuge. How do you say we are mighty and strong men for battle? Remember, like in, we just read in chapter 76 of Psalms, he says, their strong, mighty men cannot find their hands. Moab is ravaged, and her cities have been entered, and her chosen young men have gone down to the slaughter, declares the Sovereign, whose name is Yahuwah of hosts. The calamity of Moab is near to come, and his affliction hurries fast. Lament for him, all you who are around him, and all you who know his name. Say, How the strong scepter has been broken, the staff of splendor. Come down from your esteem, and sit in thirst, O inhabitant, daughter of Dabon. For the ravager of Moab shall come against you, he shall destroy your strongholds. Stand by the way and watch, O inhabitant of Aror. Ask him who flees and her who escapes. Say, what has been done? Moab has been put to shame, for it has been broken down. Howl and cry, let it be heard in Arnon, that Moab is ravaged, and judgment has come on the plain country, on Halan and on Hashtah and on Mafath, Dabon, Nebo, Beth, Diflahim. I can't say all of them. The horn of Moab has been cut off and his arm has been broken, declares Yahuwah. Make him drunk because he has made himself great against Yahuwah. Moab shall splash in his vomit, and he shall also be in mockery. And was not Yasharal a mockery to you? Was he found among thieves? For wherever you speak of him, you shake your head. Everyone I know does this. O inhabitants of Moab, leave the cities and dwell in the rock, and be like the dove making a nest in the sides of the cave's mouth. We have heard of the pride of Moab. He's very proud of his loftiness and arrogance and pride, and of the haughtiness of his heart. I know his wrath, declares Yahuwah, and his boastings are untrue, and his deeds are false. Therefore I wail for Moab, and I cry out for all Moab. I mourn for the men of Kirhias. O vine of Sibma, I weep for you with the weeping of Yazir. Your branches have passed over the sea. They have come to the sea of Yazir. The ravager has fallen on your summer fruit and your grape harvest. Joy and gladness have been taken away from the orchard and from the land of Moab. And I have made wine to cease from the wine presses. No one treads the shouting. The shouting is no shouting. From the outcry of Heshbon unto Elah, unto Hahas, Yahats, they shall raise their voice from Seor to Haranim like a three-year-old heifer. For even the waters of Nimrim are dried up, and I shall make an end of Moab. To him who offers in the high places and burns incense to his mighty ones, declares Yahuwah. So my heart sounds for Moab like flutes, and my heart sounds for the men of Kir Haris like flutes. Therefore the wealth they made shall be gone, for every head is bald, and every beard clipped, cuts on all the hands, and sackcloth on the loins. On all the housetops of Moab, and in its streets, and it is all lamentation. For I have broken Moab like a vessel, in which no one delights, declares Yahuwah. How has she been broken down? They shall wail. How has Moab turned her back with shame? So Moab shall be a mockery and a horror to all those about her. For thus said Yahuwah, see, he soars like an eagle, and he shall spread his wings over Moab. Kiriath shall be captured, and the stronghold seized. And the heart of the mighty men of Moab on that day shall be like the heart of a woman in labor. You already know. And Moab shall be destroyed as a people, because he has made himself great against Yahuwah. Fear and the pit and the snare are upon you, O inhabitant of Moab, declares Yahuwah. He who flees from the fear falls into the pit, and he who gets out of the pit is caught in the snare. For I am bringing upon Moab the year of their punishment, declares Yahuwah. Those who fled stood powerless under the shadow of Heshbon. But a fire shall come out of Heshbon, and a flame from the midst of Sion, and consume the brow of Moab, and the crown of the head of the sons of uproar. Woe to you, O Moab, the people of Chemosh have perished, for your sons have been taken into exile, and your daughters into exile. But I shall turn back the captivity of Moab in the latter days, declares Yahuwah. Thus far is the judgment of Moab. Said that Moab would be no more ravaged. You ever wonder why this spot out west is so red, different color than any other land? You ever wonder why there's what they say, what they call natural arches, why there's so many natural arches out here in this land? Moab, and all kinds of unique hieroglyphs. All you gotta do is look, my people. When I found the land, this is exactly where I started. That view you're looking at. And it brought me to right here. Straight across from Jericho, just like scripture says. I'll be back tomorrow for some Shabbat reading. Chapter 78. I love you. Shalom, shalom. Shabbat shalom. Peace out. Peace out.